Hello, Professor Hanke. Thank you for joining us today.
Good day. Good to be with you.
Could we call the collapse of Dilma Rousseff the Richard Nixon of Brazil?
I don't really believe so, because it's more similar to the 1992 impeachment of President de Mello in Brazil. And he was convicted on corruption. Remember, Nixon was not impeached on the basis of corruption. He told a tiny lie, but it was a lie, and he was impeached. De Mello is corruption, and the whole story of Brazil is corruption.
Corruption scandals, big government, many state-owned businesses, subsidized businesses legally protected from competition. This is Brazil today. How did the country end up like this, Mr. Hanke?
Well, fortunately, my good friend and mentor in all of this was Roberto Campos. And Roberto Campos is an interesting personality because, and let me just give you a little background on him. Campos was in the delegation to the Bretton Woods meeting in New Hampshire when the World Bank and IMF were formed. He also served as the ambassador to Washington and the ambassador to London. He also was a senator, and he also was part of the group who established Petrobras, the state-owned oil company, in 1953. So he knew the whole game and what was going on. And in the early 1990s, the last time I saw Roberto was in Brasilia. He had me address the Senate in Brazil, and the approach in that speech and the theme of the speech was the only way they could fix things was to install a currency board to control the fiscal affairs and put discipline in the system and start privatizing these state-owned enterprises, which are all over the place in Brazil. And the reason for that, of course, Campos thought corruption was just absolutely every place, and the only way you could get rid of it was a two-pronged currency board and massive privatization.
Okay. What's the next for Brazil? Professor Hanke, what's the right repayment plan for Brazil?
Well, I think the right approach going forward, they really have to do four things. They should put in a currency board, a big privatization program, getting rid of these state-owned enterprises, the old Campos-type plan. And the big thing is that they really need to deregulate. You said the state-owned enterprises are protected with a lot of monopoly protection provisions, so they have to deregulate the state. But the big problem, and the reason they got here, to answer your other question more directly, is that the Constitution is a disaster there. It's about as thick as a New York City telephone book, and it has everyone has rights to everything. So it's a complete disaster, and they have to start over and have a new constitution. So that'll be a long process. As you can see, they have a lot of work to do.